I'm outside the Engineering in Hove. The Engineering features very briefly in a new film, Vindication Swim, by filmmaker Elliott Hasler. I'm about to meet Elliott and find out all about it.
Elliott, we're here at the Engineering in Hove, a building full of history, which brings me nicely to asking you about your film, your passion for film, and your passion for history.
Yeah, thanks for having me in today.
Pleasure. So tell me, what got you interested, first of all, in making the film?
So I'd never heard of Mercedes Gleitze. Well, I should start with the film is it's called Vindication Swim. It's about the story of Mercedes Gleitze, who in 1927 became the first British woman to swim the English Channel. So what drew me to her story was that I'd never heard of her before I came to this project. I happened to stumble across her story in an article back in, it would have been about 2018. And I was just taken by how incredible she was as a person. She was an extraordinary woman. And she was born in Brighton in 1900, and I was born in Brighton in 2000. So it was exactly a century apart. There was a really nice kind of local connection that really sort of set the project off on a nice tone, I felt. And just researching Mercedes' story, I thought this would make a fantastic film. There's a great level of conflict in it. So there was a rival swimmer when she was doing her English Channel attempt that came along and kind of tried to usurp her glory, really. And then she was implicated in this whole cheating scandal, and they threatened to take away her claim as the first British woman to swim the English Channel. So she said, look, I will go out and I will vindicate myself through another swim, sort of hence the title, Vindication Swim.
Good title. I like the
Thank
title.
You.
That's great. A little bit about you. You are so young. You're only 23. You were very, very young when you first came across the story, wrote the script. You never studied film, is that right?
That's correct, yeah, I'm all self-taught. I've never studied film formally. When I was 14, I made a film about my great-grandfather's experience in the Second World War. So that took 3 years to make. I was 16 when it was completed. And then that got picked up for a UK and a US release, which was crazy. I mean, it was just an amateur film. It was friends and family, you know, very amateur project.
Although I have to say that latest TV director spotted your talent even then, and the film was shown on latest TV.
It was, yeah. And then off the back of kind of all that success, the film went on to get a UK-US release. It did really well in the UK. It was top 50 DVD sales, top 25 on Sky. And then off the back of that, I was able to come and do Vindication Swim.
Right, so filming yourself, you're directing, you actually held the camera as well, not in the most comfortable conditions, right? Because it was very important for you that it was done for real. In the sea, you know, no green screen, no cheating.
No cheating at all, no. Everything in this film is real. There's no tanks, no green screens, no body doubles. We're 2 miles out in the English Channel. Kirsten Callaghan playing Mercedes, she did all her own swimming for the film. There's not a single body double. She trained for 3 or 4 months in open water swimming before the production and then carried on training. I mean, it took 3 years to make this film. So that was 3 consecutive summers of Kirsten out in the water swimming as Mercedes Gleitze. But we felt that was the best way to honor this incredible woman was to do it all for real. So there's no fakery, as Mercedes was a very genuine person and we just wanted to honor her and her legacy.
Right, she did a fantastic job, Kirsten, and John Locke is so amazing. You know, there's the one scene where he kind of stands in front of the camera and, you know, with his incredible face saying something like, the sea gave me everything and it took everything. There are lots of moments in that film that are quite wow moments. And, you know, we mentioned that it's an inspirational true story. Maybe that's another link to you because, you know, your story is quite inspirational to be so young, not to have the funding from huge backers, and now to make it to over 100 cinemas in the UK. Congratulations. How do you feel about all that? It must be quite overwhelming.
It is. I mean, we never expected this level of release when we began this film. Like you say, it was a very much an independent project. You know, we didn't have much money with this film. We relied on sort of the goodwill, really, of local people in the places we filmed. We filmed a lot in Sussex, we filmed some in Birmingham, we filmed some in Kent, and local people always came in and they helped us because they loved the story of Mercedes Gleitze and they wanted to celebrate this extraordinary woman. So it's through their generosity that we were able to have this film and we managed to finish it. And then, I mean, off the back of that, there's just been this magic that the film has just, it's just snowballed, really, and different people have come on board and helped out. And then to have this release, as you say, over 100 cinemas across the UK, over 400 screenings.
So nobody will doubt that Mercedes was such an incredible woman, and the making of the film is another incredible story. Would you like to use this platform perhaps and send a message to the society, to women, to the world?
Definitely. I think the big message behind this film is one of inspiration. I mean, Mercedes tried to swim the channel 8 times and she succeeded on her 8th attempt. So I think in today's society, there's a lot of pressure on overnight success. And if you fail once, you're deemed a failure entirely. And Mercedes really went against all of that. You know, most people would have given up on maybe the second or even the first failed attempt, but she carried on, you know, 7 failed attempts before she did it. And I think that is just a fantastic trait and one that is so inspirational for people who come and see the film. And that is the kind of message that I hope people take away, is that you be inspired by Mercedes Gleitze and her legacy and, you know that your dreams are within your grasp. I think that's what Mercedes embodies, this quality that, you know, your dreams are achievable.
Right. Let's talk a little bit about filming at sea. And again, the film is a historical story. You were filming at the sea, not so far from Brighton Palace Pier, which is another historical landmark of Brighton. How did it feel to be there to film? I mean, you know, watching the film, I was getting cold, honestly. To actually film there, obviously not to mention to swim in the sea, but it must have taken ages and not the easiest, a very big challenge for someone who's just starting.
It really was, yeah. I mean, I should start by saying Kirsten actually trained by swimming around the Palace Pier. That was where she did her open water swim training. But then obviously when it came to actually filming, that was a whole other ball game. That was very, very difficult. I think it was the hardest thing that anyone on this film has ever been involved in. You know, you're at the hands of Mother Nature, and that is a very difficult thing to contend with. So there was a lot of respect that we had to have for the water. You know, we took safety very seriously. There were lifeguards, there were support boats. We had all of that, but it was still dangerous. You know, we're out there, we're 2 miles out. You know, the actors are in a small kind of rowing boat. Kirsten's in the water. For some of the shots, I'm in the water. I mean, I had a wetsuit, so I had it kind of easy. Kirsten's in a 1920s woolen swimming costume. But, you know, we had to contend with the tides, with the swell, with the wind. Sometimes we'd go out there, we'd get no shots. We'd have to abandon the shoot and come back in. You know, there were a few kind of very hairy moments. We almost lost a producer on set one time, but thankfully we didn't. And, you know, like I said, safety was taken very seriously. But it was certainly a very challenging but also very rewarding shoot.
So we know that you're keen on film. We know that you're keen on history. What about swimming?
I do swim. Yeah.
Right? But you're not going to cross the channel?
Probably not going to cross the channel. No, I like to swim in the summer. I did try swimming all year round. I got to the 1st of December and then that was just far too cold for me, so I gave up. But I accompanied Kirsten on quite a few of her training swims and I am quite a keen swimmer.
And very much a family project as well, right? Because your father has been there from the beginning, a great supporter, the producer of the movie.
Yeah, no, it has been a lovely kind of thing to work with family on this film. I mean, he was never involved in film at all before this, and then he's kind of been dragged into it because of me and because of the film and everything. But he did a fantastic job, you know, organizing everything for the shoots and things like that. And then my grandfather actually was also the production designer. So he built the sets and things. So it was lovely to kind of have this family feeling on the film. But that sort of extended outwards, and the whole project did feel very much like it was a family affair. You know, Kirsten and John and Victoria and all the actors in the film, they all sort of said this felt very much like a very much family-based project.
Yes. Right, so this is out today after 3 years. What's next for Elliott?
There's quite a few projects we've got sort of in various stages of development. There's a very exciting true crime thriller that I've co-written with Kirsten Callaghan, which is set in Brighton in the 1930s. So we're very excited about that one. Hopefully we'll be shooting on the streets of Brighton soon.
Do you know what? I have an idea for you for another film. Mercedes was very inspirational, pioneering. There's another Brighton-based woman. She wasn't born here, but she lived here. And her name was Dorothy Levitt.
Okay.
And we at Latest TV covered her story. And she was a car racing driver.
Oh, really?
She held the record at the time. That was just over 100 years ago. It's just about the centenary of her death.
Oh, okay.
So something for you to research.
Oh, that sounds very interesting. Yeah. I'll definitely look into that, yes. For sure.
How does it feel to, you know, you said that there was some kind of link between you, you know, and her in terms of the gap. Do you feel quite sort of passionately about Brighton as the venue for the film? How did it feel to, you know, to be in the Brighton scene? I know you filmed all over Sussex as well.
Yeah.
And even the engineering where we're sitting now is seen from the outside.
It is, yeah.
Did the whole thing make you more kind of connected to Brighton in a way?
Definitely. I mean, I've always felt very connected to Brighton in that I was born here, I've lived here all my life. And I think there's a nice thing about being able to share stories of your hometown. And, you know, it's very inspiring living so close to the sea that this film was all about the sea. It's about Mercedes' kind of love affair with the water. So for that to be on my doorstep as well was just brilliant. I mean, literally, I'd walk out the front door, walk down the road, and I'd be on set, essentially. It was fantastic. But, you know, we had a lot of help from people in Brighton, and Brighton's a fantastic place for films. There's lots of stunning architecture, places to film. And like I said, my next film, that's all written and set in Brighton. So I'm keen to, yeah, celebrate this city on film as much as possible.
That's wonderful. Elliott, best of luck. Come back and tell us more about your future achievements.
Thank you.
We are not turning back.
She'll never make it.
She has the try.
Ever since I was a girl, I've had a longing for the water. To swim, for me, is like nothing else in the world.
My name is Mercedes Gleitze. I'm a swimmer, and I'm told you might train me.
Cold, extreme fatigue. It's best if the strongest of men.
Well, thank God I'm a woman. I understand the water, its movements, its rhythm, and sometimes I fancy it understands me too. What if I don't make it?
I'll wager you can arrive at 1,000 reasons why you won't. All you have to do is hang on to the one that says you can.
Miss Gleitze will go down in history as the first British woman to ever swim the English Channel. Mrs. Edith Gade splashed onto the sand following the shock completion of an English Channel swim.
For this evening's honourable guest, please put their hands together in vigorous applause for Mrs. Edith Gade!
I can assure you, that woman's not to be trusted.
In this country, Miss Gleitze, an unmarried woman at your age raises suspicion. Isn't it best you step aside now and avoid further humiliation?
I did swim the town.
I know you did, but they'll never believe you.
Show them what you know to be true, that you can swim the English Channel. Come on, girl.
Are you sure you want to carry on with all this? There's no shame in quitting.
No, I'm not quitting. I've got to make it. I've got to.